Out front now, the Democratic governor of Illinois, J.B. Pritzker. Governor, a lot of that press conference was about you and your fellow governors. The president now says he's going to speak with you and your colleagues across the country, and that he's going to let you decide when you're ready to reopen your state. Obviously, yesterday he said he had the total authority to do that, that he would be making the decision. So what's your reaction? Did he cave on this?
Well, it's a good thing that the president finally recognized that it's the Constitution that authorizes the governors to have the power to reopen their states. And so I appreciate that. I think Governor Cuomo had it right when he said that, you know, the president is not a king. He's president of a United States of America. And so we're looking forward to evaluating what it is that we're going to do going forward. But the most important thing that we're going to do is focus on the safety and health of the people of our states. And in my case, you know, I've made it very clear. We need testing, tracing, contact tracing, and we need a treatment. Put that together with readily available PPE, and then you can start to talk about how you will reopen an economy.
Okay, so the president also said a few moments ago in that briefing, Governor, and I know you've got a lot going on, so I don't know how much of every word of it you heard, but he said when the testing question came up that the governors are supposed to do the testing. It's not up to the federal government. So basically, any issues, any problems are your fault, your response?
Well, that wasn't his tune earlier. In fact, let me go all the way back to when he said it was a hoax and all of us were trying to deal with it as individual governors. Illinois was the second state in the United States, I think the same day actually as California, to put our stay-at-home order in place. It's having the effect of leveling out the cases here, but we're the ones who had to spin up testing. I asked over and over again for testing from the federal government. They kept saying they were going to deliver millions of tests across the country. They haven't done that. We've done that ourselves. We have some of the best medical institutions in the entire country. They've done that work in our state labs, too. So we're producing thousands of tests. We're producing our own VTM to make sure that we've got all the supplies that we need. We've gotten very little help from the federal government. It's fine. I've given up on any promises that have been made. I hope something will get delivered from the federal government, but I don't expect it anymore.
So you're saying you've given up on them on this. You know, he also said there as he ended his press conference that there'll be severe consequences for governors if they don't get this right, basically referring to the reopening. Do you see any teeth in that threat?
Well, the severe consequence is the health and safety of the people of my state. That's the severe consequence. I mean, the president at this point is near irrelevant when it comes to this question of testing anyway. And they've done very little for us as a state. So we're doing the work. Look, we're also spinning up contact tracing. The state of Massachusetts did a great job putting a collaborative together. We're actually looking at copying that and doing that in the state of Illinois for contact tracing. And then we've ordered millions and millions of dollars worth of PPE and items of PPE that we're getting delivered from all over the world. We've had to compete with everybody, including with Donald Trump, for that PPE. But, you know, we're getting it. We're doing what we need to do despite him.
So he also just said a couple of other things that I want to make sure I give you a chance to respond to. One is he said, quote, we have to get our sports back, that he wants sports to start. His frustration, he said, was having to watch 14-year-old sports games. Obviously, the governor of California today laid out a scenario where there may not be sports games there until the fall. You obviously have major league sports teams. So what are you closer to? The Gavin Newsom world where gatherings of hundreds of people aren't in the cards and you're going to be looking out to the fall, or the president who wants his sports back and wants them back stat?
Look, I come from a sports city, Chicago. I come from a state where sports are extraordinarily important to people. We want them back, too. And we want to work hard to make sure they do come back in a safe way. But we're not going to allow sports to reopen, you know, major league sports, unless we have all of these preconditions set, because I'm not going to have tens of thousands of people getting into an arena together and giving each other COVID-19.
I mean, at this point, it sounds crazy to imagine any such thing. But, you know, the president also said that he wants to have, you know, people, the press briefing with people side by side, no social distance, that he wants that to start again, you know, that he's looking forward to that, that he wants restaurants to have 150 people in them. Is that something that you can see happening? I mean, do we literally go in any time frame that isn't many months from where we are now to everybody's just jammed all in together in your state?
Look, I think the president shares the dream that we all have that, you know, we can move past this and move past expeditiously. The challenge is that the preconditions just aren't there yet. And I know we all want this to end soon. We really do. But I'm not going to risk having another spike come and having more people hospitalized, having our hospital and health systems overwhelmed and more people dying. So we're going to do this very gradually, very carefully. I want people to get back to work just as much as the president does. But we've got to be not expeditious about it, but very careful and rely, most importantly, on the science.
All right, Governor Pritzker, I appreciate your time, and it's good to talk to you again, sir. Thank you.
Thanks, Erin.